You go see John Henry Clark or Dr. Venn, and a lot of people were lecturing, and I wanted to, you know, get a message out there celebrating the African diaspora, but I didn't want to do lectures. I didn't want to write books. There's a lot of books out there, and I wanted to, you know, express myself, you know, visually. And so I started off with one t-shirt, and our slogan is, "The sun forever rises on the children of Akibu Lawn." So I started off with that slogan and one shirt with my logo, which is on this shirt, which is the Africa set inside the sun. And we started off with that one t-shirt, and a friend of mine, who is not really into African culture, he liked the logo so much. And I said, maybe I got something here. So I started putting the logo on hats and shirts, and it just snowballed from there.
What inspired you to start this business? Jewelry and fashion.
Jewelry and fashion happened to me. It's not something that I sought out to do. What inspires me is to be able to express oneself through any type of medium, but especially in seeking, as I evolved, I was seeking to, you know, adorn myself and clothe myself accordingly, and it kind of just expanded into a business because friends, family, passersby would be like, you know, where did you get that nice, beautiful ring? And I'm like, oh, thank you, I can make you one, you know? And it kind of just evolved from there. It kind of happened to me, but what inspires me is being able to express myself.
My target audience is everyone. Like my designs, they're all one of a kind. So are I make things that will fit everyone. A librarian, a church lady, a brother with sweat. Everyone is my target audience.
Who are your heroes in the fashion industry, or fashion in general?
Well, you know, I'll tell you the truth. In terms of being a designer and the whole fashion industry, I know nothing about it. I come from a different, you know, I'm cut from a different cloth. Most of the designers have gone to fashion shoes. I don't even know how to sew. And the truth of the matter is, I don't even want to know how to sew. I just feel like in my mind, God has given me a vision to be able to see things that aren't in existence right now. Or to be able to put things together that already are in existence, but put them together in such a way that it's new. And I don't think that comes from, you know, fashion school. I think that more comes as a God-given gift. So this is really what I want to do. I want to share that gift with as many people as I can. And that's really what my object is. And to that point, it's also important for me that we create and control the things that we produce. And that's really the thing that's been missing. You know, you look at jazz music, hip hop music, you look at a lot of the things that we create, it ends up in the hands of others in terms of the control. Whereas this is something that I want us to start and also control from the ground up. So our goal ultimately is to be able to have a vertical company that actually grows the cotton, spins the cotton, you know, makes the actual fabric that, and then finishes it and actually sells it. So from the beginning, from the start to finish, we want to control it. You know, that's really my ultimate goal. I love just my house, just
other day. Your girl said that you can't stand me. I know you don't mean that.
So the name of my line, Imani Damali, is actually my name. So it's a self-titled line. And so by the way of the gods and ancestors, before I was even born, my parents decided to name me Imani Damali, which of course means faith in a beautiful vision. And so by the very name, by my name, and by everything that came afterwards, I think this is where I was meant to be, in the clothing industry with my line.
What we had.